It is the language of art that gives us hope, that makes us human, that enables us to make contact with our fellow human beings. You are born to be creative to the last breath of your life.
Scotland, as well as being widely recognised across the world for its cultural heritage, is known for being an exciting place where creativity thrives and you can experience the diversity of contemporary art forms no matter what age you are or stage you are at in life, what your abilities are, or where you live. Within Scotland, there are 866 care homes for older people, housing a diverse collection of people. We are going to be visiting just three of these homes and finding out what each of them do to give their residents the opportunity to experience different art forms in a way that offers some challenge and the chance to fully participate. Some art sessions will be run by professional artists and some by care staff, but whoever it is, being flexible, good planning and a good experience for the resident are some of the keys to success. But first, we're in Glasgow to speak to someone who has first-hand experience of working in the arts and care homes.
My name's Janie Nicol. I'm a visual artist based in Glasgow, and recently I've done a couple of quite big projects working with care homes. So this has involved working with people with dementia and really quite frail people, sort of end-of-life care. I would say that what I do is sort of enable people to be creative again, which is really kind of interesting. And it can come out in different ways, you know. It might, when you're working with people, it might just be that they've got beautiful writing. And I suppose I see my role as kind of harnessing that and working with it and seeing what we can kind of come up with in that kind of process.
Janie's come to the Haining Care Home in Falkirk to begin a six-week workshop. She's hoping to engage with the residents so they participate in some visual art activities they have carefully planned together.
When Janie comes along to do the sessions, she may find it difficult to get engaged with the residents and also for the residents to remain throughout the activity. Also, she might find the communication difficult with the residents.
We're going to do some drawing, okay? Oh, fancy doing a wee drawing for me?
I can enjoy.
Oh, I think you possibly can. Everybody, people always tell me they can't, and I know they can. And then they do, and it's not a problem. It's very common for me to be working in these kind of situations and for people to be either quite hesitant or a bit reluctant to say that they can't draw. The biggest challenges I would say are, I mean, they're not necessarily a bad thing, but you know, communication skills, working with people who might be, say, profoundly deaf or have very limited capabilities. So that's something that you have to kind of overcome gradually, I think.
It's Valentine's Day in Perth, and the activity coordinator at Moncrief Care Home, along with a group of residents, has been inspired to run a special art session using the spoken word, thanks to two of the home's most popular residents.
We have a lovely couple here at Moncrief Home who've been married a fair bit of time, and they are still sweethearts. They still love each other very, very much.
Mum and Dad are very close. They've never been parted in all these years. They'd always done everything together and still do, even come into the care home together.
Well, we met when we was 18, and as I say, I chased her all over Perth very near, trying to catch her. And our first date was the pictures. And they both married, been married 74 years.
Every month I do what's called a Living Voices session, and it's a themed session, which obviously we've chosen Valentine's Day today. and the arts and crafts people have been working for at least a couple of weeks on that theme. Everybody loves Donald and Jean. So we decided to do Valentine's Day specially around Donald and Jean. And they are stars in their own right, you know, they're absolutely super people.
We're lucky now we're back in this home now. I mean, this is the end of our career now. For, at 94, I can't look for much more. You understand? And Jean's getting well looked after, and that's the main thing. I couldn't have picked a better woman right enough than Jean. She's been good to me all these years. Man. Hey, Jean.
I don't know.
Back at the Haining, the residents are starting to get really involved in the art session, and it's having quite an impact.
The project's gone really well. It was really interesting, and the people that I was working with were really quite into it, I think. So, and kind of got on and were quite productive.
Patricia rarely participates in activities at all. And then with some encouragement, showing her how to draw with a pen in her hand, we left her and she started drawing pictures herself and colouring those pictures in.
She seemed to get a lot out of it. She was quite hesitant to start off with, but really got into the drawing and worked really well.
You know that you're not creating a wonderful painting, but you know you are trying to do something with the time that you have. But all sort of growing up and getting older and all the rest of it, I always drew a tree. But those are the only things I ever drew. Ladies' faces and a tree.
I started painting when I was young, I think that's what it is, right through. Well, I enjoy the colours and the satisfaction of the doing it, being done, you know.
Because of my complaint of Parkinson's and Alzheimer's, when I try to write a signature, normally it would be straight across, but this goes up and down, it's hopeless.
Bill, who has Parkinson's, was at an art session just the other day, and it was nice to see him taking part. He felt at first that he wasn't going to be able to do it because of the shaking motions with his hands, but once he picked up the paintbrush and started, that actually decreased because he was concentrating so hard to try and do a nice picture.
He seemed a lot more comfortable, you know, after the first week. I think they got into the whole thing quite quickly, all seemed to work really smoothly overall. I would say never underestimate anybody because you can always be surprised about what people can actually do with a bit of coaxing and encouragement.
Easter has come at Moncrieff and the residents have decided to make some Easter cards and decorations. One resident in particular has really begun to get involved in the activities and enjoys the challenge it brings.
Greta just came into the home the same week as I started, and I was very conscious of the fact that she was looking around quite bewildered because she had no idea how she became ill and she had no idea why she was put into a home. I discovered that Greta used to love drama and arts and crafts, and she always says, I wanted to be a cook, I didn't want to work in the bank. I love working with my paws, and that's what she calls her hands. I love working with my paws.
Oh, I love being in here making a lot of these things. I love doing all that. These are the two things I love working with. We cut out all these items and then we paint them or what you see on them, and then we put other things on them and design them. I think it's good for here, the brain,
you know, to keep us active, because that, this has to be exercised as well, I suppose.
At least three times a week we do arts and crafts, and she's right in there, and she's fantastic. She likes to personalise whatever it is that she's doing. She's absolutely brilliant at helping the others as well.
I wasn't an expert drawer or, you know, artist in any way, but I still liked, and I still to this day like working with my hands. I had a very sad life in my early days, but it didn't stop me from enjoying life in the latter days of my life.
At Belleville Nursing Home in Edinburgh, the staff and residents like to participate in different art forms, both inside and outside the care home. These include poetry sessions, dancing, music sessions, and trips out to visit some of the different museums in the city.
My mother, she has a degree in fine art. When she came here, it was very important to me that this was a place where she'd still be able to explore her passion for art and literature and music. And she absolutely loves getting out and about and going to museums and galleries and music performances. It's really enriched her life at this time in her life in a way that I hadn't thought was going to be possible. But it is, because she lives here and because the staff here are encourage that.
I think it's when your heart stops beating is when you stop being creative. I think it is just something that we continually do, and that can, as I say, can be huge big things or simple things. But engaging with other people's creativity is in itself creative.
Has Grandma got an electric licht? Is the next stop Kirkcaldy?
When James actually chose a poem that they recognised, their faces totally lit up, and to see them reciting something that they must have known for a very long time, sometimes, you know, they might have forgotten it, but it's still there, and the joy that they had in actually recalling it and joining in, that was something to see. It's great.
People have different interests and they like to do different things, so that's why we try to keep it sort of fresh and use things in different ways, whether it's reminiscence, whether it's having a sing-song session, whether it's, yeah, different things, looking at objects and talking about them. But I think it's trying to cater for different people.
I remember a couple of years ago doing a piece, and a woman who was 100 who was asleep, and we started singing Keep Right On to the End of the Road, and she woke up and she held my hand and she sang every single word. And for me, that is not, you know, without being kind of old hippie or anything, but it was a really precious moment, because in that moment we were both part of, you know, Glasgow that afternoon. We made a connection. There's an equality in that moment, just sharing and being together and finding common ground. That's so important, so important. And I hope, if I'm fortunate enough to get older, that people will value my contributions, no matter what age I am.
Cheers! Bottoms up! Down the hatch! But pleasures are like poppies spread. You see the flower, its bloom is shed. Or like the snow falls in the river, a moment white, it melts forever.
I think it is the immediacy, it's the personal contact, it's some degree of emotional engagement that has built up over time as well. And I think these are all the component parts that lead up to somebody like Mardy being able to engage in an activity like that, in which people are engaged in a human level. That's applicable and necessary for all of us.
This is something that any care home can do. By using the skills of care staff or by employing a professional artist, residents can be creative and be opened up to new experiences.
Once they're doing something, they think, I never knew I could do that. And they enjoy it. So it's never ever too late for them to try and do something different or something new.
It's all about communication. It's all about, I feel, hitting something in the brain that sparks the memories. And if they're good memories, you can see the change in their face, and then they want to share. And it's quite exciting to see what comes out of it.
A poem, a song, a painting by anybody is valid no matter where they do it in their journey from A to B. We've also got to stop seeing it just as an activity, as you know, to pass the time. But it's a valid way of expressing yourself.
You can look at creativity up here, but up here probably, if you started thinking about it yourself, you'd probably be just as creative as other people. So that's what I hoped I would be. And indeed, I suppose I ended up by being very happy with it. And I can see the results of our efforts in here every time I come in.
Keep on going. Because you really don't know where you're going to develop, do you? I mean, you do something, you keep on going, you develop into something better or different.
Sometimes it's a revelation for people that they can actually be creative. And I think it can also be a comfort for people as well, because they might have problems with communication, and it's a way of expressing themselves. So yeah, I think it kind of enriches people's lives if they can be creative.
It's such a human thing to be creative and do whatever you want to do. And that, over the years, putting people into categories of you're creative, you're not creative, you're artistic, you're not. These categories don't mean anything now, but people are been told them and they stick pretty much by them. So we're all artists.